two red-hot teams right here, just as we're about to get underway with the Triple M Queensland Premier Rugby semi-final SBC Sevens World Series. As you see, Tom Kibble get the ball back to Bobby Tuttle, who gives a short ball there to Alfonso Horamaya, who does what he does best and hits that line hard. And Wyatt Setu does the exact same, does what he does best and affects his 33rd turnover of the season. Strikes it, and that's flags. Coming good at the right end of the season as we see some strong pressure from Jeeps here, but good quick ball. Sam Wallace at the back of the scrum. Targets the Jeeps defensive line. And they're playing it slow here as Wakely just takes a settler straight into Mitch King, who gets it out. Jimmy Dalgleish. Jimmy Dalgleish burrows over, and Jimmy Dalgleish gets first five-pointer of the match for the student 17 minutes in.
Great drop.
As Jimmy Dalgleish fires and hammers it straight through. Takes it into contact as Horamaya steps into half. And Tommy Kibble, the young man, first year out of school. And Pat Murray's off his feet there. But he's gotten away with it. Jordan Way said he was sweet as we see Con Foley marching upfield. And McDermott now there going down the far side is Will Eady. Will Eady, the jet shoes. Paul Mercurio tiptoes his way through. Will Eady. Will Eady, the youngster, scores from a mile out. That is an absolute perler.
There's no one over the breakdown. It's not a ruck.
Got a play to the whistle as we see Jimmy Dalgleish just sneeze that one over with ease. As they hit straight in the middle to Dan Gorman. An absolute pillar of strength in this Jeeps forward pack. And they are well set up here. And they are rolling here forward. They are steaming up. And this Jeeps Maul is well set up as we see. It looks like even John O'Kent, the wing, is getting in the mixer now. Some of the backs are looking to get a bit of a sniff. And they've got the advantage now, and Jeeps are starting to dictate how well they play here with the short ball to Horamaya.
Tackle by Foley.
Gets chopped down low. As we see Albert Nicoro doing what Albert Nicoro does best, and that's running lines and scoring tries.
He struggled a little bit off the tee, but he's been working really hard during the week with former Reds and Jeeps Premier Grade head coach Shane Arnold.
Utlet.
Great seed.
Has to whip a wobbly one out the back as we see a good clearance out over the 50, but no, does not find touch as we see Jock Campbell dancing into contact. We'll really want to find some grass real quick as Dan Gorman's looking to sneak in as we see Tate McDermott dart down that far side with a short ball to Pat Murray, who gets it out to Angus Scott Young. Here's Scott Young to Will Eady. Will Eady, too easy.
Tell you what, that's outstanding work once again down the short side from Tate McDermott. We're looking to keep a clean score sheet here.
Great strike.
And that's a perler from Jimmy Dalgleish as he absolutely snots it over. Dolly Bartlett takes the contact and Tuttle clears to JP Smith, who throws the ball out to his front row partner in Ryan Freeney, who throws a bit of a bludger, but cleaned up there from Davis Tevita.
I like the skills there from the front row there, J-Ball.
They're linking up well in midfield, aren't they, as we see them do it again right there, but they haven't picked up on that knock on from Ruan Smith, so play on, says the ref. And Tommy Kibble again, as we've seen for the first 35 minutes of this game, he's absolutely everywhere.
That's a good pick and go.
And that's a great pick and go from Smith, who gets to Horamaya, who plays as an extra back rower for this Jeeps outfit. You can see them picking and going and just trying to chew those metres up close to the ruck. Smith hit by his opposite number, Richardson. As we see Horamaya again getting in and doing the hard stuff. Tuttle had runners, but he just had a bit of a slip in the hand. We'll see some pick and goes and the tight stuff here from Jeeps as Mitch King goes over, and Mitch King gets the try for Jeeps.
Great response here by Jeeps. Well done, Mitch King.
As Bobby Tuttle takes his time, walks in and hammers it straight through the middle, does Bobby Tuttle. Well, we've got a big 40 minutes coming up in this Triple M semi-final. I think Ruan Smith is just really doing a good number on him.
Down.
Ruan Smith has got
straight
him
for the weight.
A great
That's
setup
strong.
Here, but
That's
this
good.
Is a strong
here he goes.
Set piece. But we can see Jeeps coming forward now.
Well, yes.
And they bounce back down the far side. Albert Nicoro gets that short ball.
Trelevin.
And it looks like Mitch Trelevin has just danced straight over and picked up a five-pointer for Jeeps. Bobby Tuttle steps up. He's curled it back, and that's a great kick. And they're close here to students. They just want to maintain position.
Oh, Thompson.
But they were close there. As we see Siakasini. He's over there, but he spilt the beans.
Off first glance, I thought he got it down, but I'll take the knock on.
I'd like to see the, here it is in the replay. Siakasini gets low. And then he goes close to the line.
I've got to go in with Jordan Way there. If anyone's in a good position, it's Jordan Way. I can tell you right now, not me. I'm nervous just up here calling the game. And this is a good, strong platform here, but they've got to go out. Bobby Tuttle gets it out to Davis Tavita. Davis Tavita isolated, but he's still able to get the ball back as Horomaya goes into this. Channel 9 roll, but Tom Kibble throws a short ball that goes down low there. But Pat Murray's all over that, and he's affected the turnover, and the students have got the penalty. Pat Murray with the turnover.
Wow. What a finish. Murray straight on the ball, affecting the turnover and the penalty.
There it is. Jimmy Dalgleish buries it into the eighth row. And the University of Queensland defeat Jeeps 24 points to 21 in this Triple M Queensland Premier Rugby semi-final.